Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong. Hello and welcome. This is Daystar Christian Center. We call it the home of stars and mega stars. It's a special one in our church today. It's our annual Christmas concert, and it's such a joy to have you join us today and be a part of this beautiful experience of lifting up Christmas carols, enjoying powerful, beautifully arranged music from our worship team. It promises to be an exciting one today. So if it's your first time being in Daystar Christian Center, joining us wherever you're watching us from, whether in your hotel room, in your kitchen, in your living room, we want to warmly welcome you into our Christmas concert today. If it's your first time, we'd like to connect with you. A link is showing on the screen right now. Send us your detail. We have some information we'd like to share with you. We'll also want to foster this relationship that we're starting with you today. I believe you are ready. If you are ready, we are ready. Please, wherever you are, will you please put your hands together and welcome with me the best choir in the world, the Healing Streams of God.
Amen. The baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love it, Lord Jesus, look down by my side and stay by my side until morning is night.
Sensing the King of Glory is here. I can trial, I triumphed. Condemned so I could gain heaven's recommendation. This is my testimony. Oh, 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 oh.
Never call your own.
You give me joy. Your spirit comes me always. When I was lost, you made a way. Oh, Jesus, this is my. Praise our God with me. Praise the Lord. You say.
Hallelujah. Come on.
For all he's done for you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For coming just for me and you.
Wow, were you blown away by those renditions? Yes, it's been awesome. And so at this point, we just want to take time out to welcome everyone that is watching our broadcast for the very first time. This is Daystar Christian Center. We call it the home of stars and megastars. We have just one assignment from God, and that is to raise role models. We have a promise from God that when you do the things that are being taught by our pastor and other pastors through this platform, you join our small group system, you take advantage of the trainings that we have available. God gave us a promise that in as short as 3 months, it would have so much so transformed your life that all the people that knew you before would testify of the remarkable changes that would have taken place in you. What a day to connect with us, the day where we're celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we want to invite you to be a part of this family. This is a family that transforms life. We have loads of testimony in our church of people never experiencing a better last year, and that will be your testimony. There's a link that is showing on the screen right now. Please go to that link, give us your details. We'd like to foster this new relationship we're starting with you today. For being a part of this concert, I pray that you will experience the comfort of that Jesus brought into our world like you've never before, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that the peace of this season and the joy of this season will guard your heart, overflow your heart in the mighty name of Jesus. And to take us further in this Christmas concert, there is a special word for you from our senior pastor. Please join me as we welcome our pastor. Please put your hands together and receive with me Pastor Sam Adeyemi.
Hello and welcome everyone to our Christmas concert for this year. We are excited. And I hope you also are excited. Wow. What do you think about all of the presentations we've had so far and the ones that are still going to come? This is amazing. Right from our junior church to the Star Hub, yeah, to the Healing Streams of God, to our praise team. Everybody's just so amazing today. Please help me to give them a big, big hand clap. Ah. Thank you. a lot of work went into preparing for this day and night. We really appreciate you. And I'd like to very specially appreciate our music director, Dr. Seyi Kenny. Wow. Awesome. We appreciate Dr. Seyi Kenny so. I mean, as you can see, our church is loaded, power packed. Dr. Seyi Kenny is an assistant professor and sub-dean of the Faculty of Arts at the University of Lagos. And we're just so grateful for all of the experience and skill and leadership that he brings into all of this. Okay, so comforter. That's the person we are talking about this season, because Christ is the reason for Christmas. And I just want to remind you of what he said. Let me remind you quickly and we continue with the singing. John chapter 14 and verse 16 from the King James Version of the Bible. John 14, 16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. What do the headlines say today? There's war in Ukraine every day. Inflation exploding everywhere, right? Kidnapping, at least in Nigeria. Terrorist attacks here and there. Shooting practically every day. And protests erupting everywhere around the world. Isn't that amazing? Protests erupting everywhere. And the experts have told us we're going to have a lot of those protests in the next few years, because things are just so rough in our world. Don't you think we need help right now? This is a good time for us to remember we are not alone in this world. Jesus Christ said, I am going to pray the Father, and he will give you, pay attention to the words, another. So, which means there was a comforter already. Now, who was that comforter? Jesus Christ, of course. Jesus Christ, the original comforter. And he was saying to his disciples, I know, because I'm telling you guys that I'm leaving and you guys are sorrowful. Don't worry. I'm not going to leave you like orphans. I'll give you another comforter. With that use of the word another, he helped them to have a clear picture of what this comforter was coming to do, since it was going to be another. So all they had to do was to see what Christ, or who Christ had been to them. And this other comforter that was coming would be exactly that. Jesus Christ, the comforter, had been their provider. You won't see anywhere that they were hungry and lacking for food or lacking for anything. As long as Christ was around, God was around, every challenge was turned into a miracle. No food on the crusade ground, miracle of multiplication of loaves and fish. Woo! Peter, when Christ met Peter, Peter and his friends tried to catch fish. They could not catch fish all through the night in Luke chapter 5. Jesus Christ came, used Peter's boat to preach, and then told him, launch out into the deep, throw your net for a catch. In the same sea where they caught nothing, they got abundance. So when Christ was around, they had no fears, no concerns, right? They were riding in a boat. He was sleeping. There was a storm. Water was pouring into the boat. They were bailing out the water because it occurred to them, the comforter. He is here. So they went to wake him up. Masters, don't you care? We are perishing. And then he said, you guys need to be able to handle things like this on your own. Anyway, storm, peace, calm down. And even just, right? That's the comforter. It's a comforter. There was a day, you know, he had been healing people and all that, and then they were moving in between towns. They were moving between towns. Everybody happy, excited for the miracles that had happened. And then they met another crowd. Very sad crowd. A young man had just died, the only son of his mother. Mother was a widow. So this woman lost her husband, now she lost her son. What was going to be left? She was very sad. Everybody was sad. They were going to bury the guy. So the happy crowd with the comforter met the sad crowd. One crowd was going to change the other one. It was either the happy crowd was going to join the sad crowd in crying, or the sad crowd were going to join the happy crowd. Of course, the crowd that will have the upper hand is the one where you have the comforter. Jesus went straight to the source of the sadness, touched the coffin, and said, "Young man, stand up." The young man stood up. He said, "Jesus delivered him to his mother. Thank you, Jesus." That is what happens when you have the comforter in your boat, you have the comforter in your life. He turns challenges into opportunities for miracles. He turns sadness into joy. He turns lack into abundance. So, right now, the temptation is for us to be fixated in all that is going on in our world. And that makes our joy to go up and down. So much fear, so much concern. Take your eyes off the storm. And I just wanted to say today, remember, you have the comforter with you. You have the comforter with you. So whatever is the source of the sadness, whatever is the source of concern, whatever is the source of the pain, today, I speak to it. The comforter touches it. The power of God destroys whatever is causing discomfort, whatever is causing pain. In the name of Jesus Christ, I prophesy in your life a turnaround, a miracle turnaround. This Christmas, I declare today, is the best Christmas you have had in your life until now, in the name of Jesus Christ. The original comforter is Jesus Christ. He said, "I will send another." And you know, I found out, therefore, that now Jesus Christ is with us, but it's the Holy Spirit actually that we have. He's invisible. But you've got to learn to talk to him like you would talk to Jesus if he was here physically, right? Cultivate your relationship with him. As we move into the new year, it's going to be the best year you had in your life until now in the name of Jesus. Listen, if you were confused before today, I pray in Jesus' name that the Comforter will give you direction. He will tell you what to do. You know, when I don't know what to do, let's say it's about my job, about ministry, about business, or it's even about marriage, or about parenting, you know what I do? I ask the Comforter. I ask the Comforter. And then when I say what he says or do what he does, people think I'm really, really smart. Thank you, Jesus. Our smartness is in the Comforter. Our power is in the Comforter. The Comforter is the source of our joy. Hallelujah. So I pray in Jesus' name that this will be a beautiful season for you. Right? Can you bow your head with me a moment and let's pray? Will you speak to the Comforter right now? Can you ask him to help you? Can you ask him for wisdom? Can you ask him to make himself so real to you, you will know you are not alone? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Heavenly Father, we're grateful to you. We're grateful to you. And today we're declaring, we're celebrating the Comforter. We're celebrating you, celebrating Jesus Christ. And today we remember more than any other day that the greatest problem of this world is sin. Gives Satan the opportunity to wreak havoc in our lives. And then also we remember you solved the problem for us. Because when Jesus was to come, the angel said, "You shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." Since he died on the cross and rose on the third day, you have credited his death into our account because he was actually sinless. He paid for us. So Heavenly Father, I present to you everyone today who wants to receive forgiveness of sins. We thank you because you love us and you will do it. If you're that honest person who says, Pastor, please pray with me that God should forgive my sins. I'm a sinner. My relationship with God is not okay. I think today is the best opportunity. Can you put your hand on your heart? Let's pray together. God bless you for your honesty. Can you put your hand on your heart? Okay, so say this prayer after me. Dear God, I believe that Jesus paid for my sins. I ask you to forgive me and to accept me as your child. Thank you for hearing my prayer. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, thank you for everyone that said this prayer. Jesus said there is joy in heaven among the angels when this happens. So we're all just so excited for them. And we just pray, Heavenly Father, just teach them to know you as comforter, to cultivate a personal relationship with you. Teach them to love you and to love other people the rest of their lives. In Jesus' name. Amen. Woo! Congratulations if you said that prayer. Congratulations. If you're at any of our physical locations, right, our ushers give you a card while we're praying. Please fill it with accurate information right away. We have very powerful information we're going to send to you that will be very useful to you. Okay? When we close the service in a few minutes, just leave the card on your seat. We'll pick it up as soon as you leave the seat. Or you may hand it over to any of our ushers. If you're online, there's a link in the chat room. Click on it. Give us your information. We'll send what we have to you via email. All right, if you're on TV, the link is also there on the screen. Please copy it and then go on your browser. Give us your information. We'll send what we have to you. God bless you in Jesus' name. All right, so on behalf of my beautiful wife, Pastor Nike, our children, our family, it's a Merry Christmas from our family to yours with love. We love you. Let's welcome back our worship team for the beautiful presentations we still have for this service. Bye for now.
Yeah. Thanks unto the Lord.
till it. Sing hallelujah.
Celebration. celebration. Tell me what you do.